So here's the folk theorem. Any feasible payoff profile that strictly dominates the min-max or security level profile can be realized as a Nash equilibrium payoff profile with a sufficiently large discount factor.
Prove it.
What we're going to do is we're going to construct a way of behaving where both players are going to play so that they achieve this feasible profile. And the reason to make that a Nash equilibrium, what we need to do is make it so that it's a best response. And the way that we're going to make it a best response is we're going to say, do what you're told, follow your instructions to achieve that feasible payoff. And if you don't, then the other player is going to attack you, is going to adopt a strategy that forces you down to your min-max or your security level, and that's your threat. So the best response to that threat is to just go along and do what you're told to achieve that feasible payoff. The only way that that's going to be stable, though, is if the thing that you're asked to do, the feasible payoff, is better than the min-max, right? Because that has to be a threat. You can't threaten somebody and say, you know, do this or I'm going to give you candy. it's got to be do this or I'm going to give you something that's less pleasant than what I've asked you to do.
Okay. That actually makes sense.
Yeah, so this is a really cool idea.
I like it. Hey, could you try saying that again, but with like a Southern accent? Just the folk theorem part?
Any feasible payoff profile that strictly dominates the min-max security level profile can be realized as a Nash equilibrium payoff profile with sufficiently large discount factor.
I like that because now it's a Folksy theorem.